final day of the Kyalami three-day test out in South Africa. Been a pretty interesting one. There's been a lot of new motorbikes, a lot of riders swapping seats. It's been first day was really summarised by Noriyuki Haga, three crashes on first time out on the Xerox Ducati, which took a lot of people by surprise. First one he tangled with Jonathan Ray, literally on his second lap out. Second time he high-sided, and then just when we thought he kind of got to grips with the bike, he had another crash really right at the end of the day. So bit of a shock there. The team remained calm. Since then, done some new leathers, new camouflage leathers, which take a bit of getting used to. And he's been quick and got quicker and quicker. End of the second day, he kind of made a bit of a breakthrough on the setup, and it's been noticeable. I was out on track earlier today, and he looks smooth, he looks comfortable, and then the lap times show that he's very fast. So I think Haga has got some grips with it. He's made some quite drastic changes to the bike, which have been instrumental in him feeling comfortable. Currently, Michel Fabrizio, with about an hour left of the test, Fabrizio has been the man really in the test all 3 days. He's been very, very fast. Not necessarily the most consistently quick guy out there, but very, very quick on a single lap. Tends to go out, put a fast lap in early on, and then the pace drops off by about half a second. But even with that half a second drop off, he's looking good and he's looking strong. Personally, I think this could be bit of pressure being relieved of him, given now that Bayliss has left the team, because having Troy Bayliss, who was obviously very, very fast any given track, any given session, it's obviously very, very difficult. Like I say, we've got just over an hour left of the test, so times could change, but currently Jonathan Ray is that second quickest, which is quite good for British fans, and maybe even a little bit more than he expected. As a third rider in the team, he doesn't get use of all the prototype Pirelli tyres that have been bought. But because of his pace, he did get given some qualifiers this morning. He decided to go out early on this morning and made the most of the cooler conditions. It has been very, very hot out here in South Africa. He's, like I say, currently second quickest and looking very, very good. Holds out on track, he's sliding the bike, but he does look very, very comfortable on it. He's done an awful amount of laps, and I think right now I spoke to him earlier and he's pretty jaded, to be perfectly honest, but gone through a whole host of electronic setups, which he's been working on this afternoon, but before that, just really trying to get a base setting for the bike and get himself feeling comfortable. Swing arm changes, link changes, rear shock changes, front foot suspension changes, just altering the balance of the bike. Other big surprises for me have been the 2009 Alphastar Suzuki. They had one shakedown test in Phillip Island a couple of weeks ago, but they've come here and been very, very quick. Kageyama looks like his old self. Bit wild, but fast and consistent, very, very consistent actually. If you look beyond the sort of headline grabbing, you know, real fast lap, Kageyama's been very, very good. Neukirchner as well, that's very, very smooth out on track, and it looks like the balance of that bike is working very, very well. Very opposing styles, Kageyama and Neukirchner, but it does seem that the bike is working. Aprilia had pretty strong days on the first couple of days, but this afternoon they've run into a few technical problems, which has left Biaggi with one bike and Akana with one bike. At one stage, Akana looked like he developed another electrical problem on his second bike, looked like he was going to cancel his test. Akana's been impressive actually, as a GP guy, a lot less experience than someone like Biaggi on a superbike, but I guess he's just showing his class really and what he should be doing, and he's come here and certainly in the first couple of days he's and looking at consistent times, he's hovering around the top 6, top 7 mark, which I think on a new bike is particularly impressive. The rest of the Honda guys, Kianari and Checa isn't, I think, a big fan of the track. The track is bumpy and they're having a few issues with that, but you know, as a professional rider he is, he's plugged away and his lap times have come, and he's looking pretty strong, he's looking consistent. Again, he's just working on fine-tuning the setup of the bike. He's actually reverted back to the HRC kit swing arm, which looks just like standard. from the K-Arsling arm, which is a pretty special looking thing that he used most of the season. I spoke to him about this. His sort of theory is that he really wants to be working with Honda and working with Honda components in an effort to get more help from them. Kianari seems to have taken a long time to gel with the circuit, which is obviously something we've seen consistently from him in the past. He finds it hard to be quick straight away. But today he seems to have made a little bit of a breakthrough, and the times are coming. He out of everyone has done the most laps, so he's flat out testing, certainly not giving up. Aside from that, you have the BMW guys. I think it's fair to say that the BMW is probably the least developed bike out here. Even though the Aprilia is all new, BMW, they really don't have a lot of racing experience, especially at this level. Whereas obviously Aprilia have got years and years of 250GP, and obviously have had spells in WSB and obviously MotoGP. The BMW, it looks strong engine-wise, but I think they're having a few problems with just throttle connection, and I don't think it's particularly clean when they're coming from an off-closed throttle to an open throttle. So they're working on a lot of things, but I think generally the balance of the bike is okay. Speaking to Zaus and Forza, they're actually pretty optimistic about the lap times they're doing, because they know that they don't have as much experience, and they know that they don't have anywhere near as much data as an established team such as Yamaha, Honda or Ducati. So they feel reasonably confident in what they've achieved here so far. And even if they're not at the timesheet, I think they feel there's a lot of potential in the bike. Talking to the team manager there, he thinks there's at least 2 seconds in the bike. And they're actually, those guys are actually running without any sort of traction control, which has been evident when you're watching Zaus out on track. He's his normal flamboyant self and doing quite a lot of sliding. That's pretty much it for the final day. Like I say, we've got just over an hour left, so I think that we've got quite a lot of cloud cover now. Although it's still very hot, I think the track temperature should go down a little bit. Currently we're running at over 50 degree track temperature, which is very hot, and generally the Pirellis don't work quite so well when the temperature is that high. So I think, as we've seen in the last couple of days, the last sort of 40 minutes of the day is when the qualifiers come out and we see some real hot times. We've actually just had a red flag since I've been speaking, so the track is currently closed. But I'm sure the guys will get out there now, and we'll see how the final timesheets end up.